is fine. And when everything is breaking that you would keep inside, now your eyes ain't moving now. You just lay there in your cloud. Two-headed boy. Creating a radio bell just for two in the parlor with the moon across her face. With the music he sweetly displays, silver speakers that sparkle all day, made for his lover who's floating.
Stay on.
it's licking sweetly. So thick that it was deafening. I cannot hear above the sugar, but I can watch your mouth move. The second time I'll hear completely. Faces are reading as bleak. Search some sand out of the city.
I left my drink over there. Can I? I left my drink.
my water. Sorry. I'll slate again.
Oh.
It's weird to be like in the sun. Normally I hate it, but. Wait, do you want me to set a slate again? No. All right.
Arrived. Omelet beneath my fingernails. She snags. On rosebuds for breakfast. Thank you. daily. Plaster pores. When you make somebody something.
Hi everyone, I'm Steve Reidell. I'm a musician here in Chicago. Maybe you've seen me around. If not, here's a short resume. I'm half of the band Air Credits, along with the legend Show You Suck. I'm part of a newer project called Surgery Boys with Johnny Kaluuya from Verma and Joe Carcello from Lasers and Fast and Shit. Over the last few years, I've been playing the bass for Black Moss Super Rainbow and Tobacco from Pittsburgh. I'm also one half of the Hood Internet, a DJ duo from here that for the last decade have mostly specialized in combining things musically. And that's tied in here because combining things musically is the same thing that the soundtrack to the movie Judgement Night set out to do in 1993. The soundtrack has 11 songs by rock bands paired up with rap groups. And there are some pretty amazing artists on here, and we'll go through them all in a minute. This record was huge for me. It came out my freshman year of high school, very formative time for musical taste. And I found out about it like I found out about a lot of cool music from my best friend Peter, who had cable TV, specifically MTV, who were still playing music videos at that time. Peter put me on to so much new music. This is the dude that gave me a ministry record as a Christmas present the year before. And when he'd hit me to this soundtrack to a movie that I hadn't seen, the music and the whole concept of it really felt electric. I mean, at the time, this kind of collaboration seemed somehow out of bounds. Musical genres and their fans were a lot more divisive in 1993 than they are today. So this felt like, proper noun, a new thing. Of course, by this time, there were a couple pretty well-known cross-genre collabs already out there in the world. Walk This Way by Run DMC and Aerosmith, Bring the Noise by Public Enemy and Anthrax, but the Judgement Night soundtrack was a whole album of new collabs from a really solid roster of cool artists. Now, if you're unfamiliar with the movie Judgement Night, I'm not surprised, but here's the short version. Emilio Estevez, Stephen Dorff, Cuba Gooding Jr., and Jeremy Piven are a bunch of suburban dads who are rolling in a luxury RV on their way into Chicago for a boxing match, and then they get lost in bad Chicago because it was 1993 and GPS or smartphones didn't exist yet.
What do you say, fight fans?
A night out on the town. A heavy traffic jam.
Tell you something, I'm not going to miss this fight.
And one wrong turn.
So, anyway, shit goes foul, and they get wrapped up in some gang activity, led by notorious Chicago gang leader Dennis Leary, whose gang members include Everlast from House of Pain. There he is. Okay, so I know this is liner notes, and I'm not really doing this to talk about the movie, but I am doing this to talk about Everlast, because the first song on the Judgement Night soundtrack pairs up House of Pain with Helmet. So here's some of that one. This is called Just Another Victim. So that's Helmet doing their thing. Let's fast forward a bit to the House of Pain section of the song.
I built the house, I felt the pain. You victimized, but got no one to blame. Just another victim. You're just another victim, kid. Holy diver, I'm a survivor. Feeling like De Niro in Taxi Driver with Jodie Foster and Harvey Keitel. Looks like I'm walking through a living hell.
Lengthy IMDb level shout out to the movie Taxi Driver there by Everlast. So that's the lead track. Interesting fact, this whole soundtrack was executive produced by a music industry guy named Happy Walters. His label Immortal Records released the soundtrack. A part of Happy's vision for this was to just bring sonically different but like-minded genres together, which he would continue to do in later years with the Spawn and the Blade 2 soundtracks. But he also managed House of Pain and Cypress Hill, so having them specifically on there was for sure part of the move. Cypress Hill even got two different songs on this. Okay, track 2, easily one of the best, if not the best on here, Fallen by Teenage Fan Club and De La Soul.
Hey yo kids!
What's up?
Remember when I used to be dope?
Yeah.
I own a pocket full of fame.
But well, look what you're doing now.
I know. Well, I know.
Oh, your brains are so good. Your brains are so good.
So the hook on this one samples Tom Petty's Free Fallin', and Teenage Fan Club are basically repeating a variation of that chord progression, but with their approach to hip-hop drums and tempo. And they find a pretty nice groove. De La Soul, seasoned veterans, really shine here. This song sounds like it was pure joy to work on. There's a little bit of this one in that Hood Internet 1993 mix. Another quick fun fact about this song, the Tom Petty sample means that your guy Jeff Lynn has a writing credit on the Judgement Night soundtrack. Here's track 3, Living Color with Run DMC. This kind of collab isn't exactly new territory for Run DMC, which is probably why this one also feels kind of on the Walk This Way side of things.
I'm never alone, I'm in a zone, it's known. I never leave home without my microphone. I break back bones like a stone I roll. I think that's better, wacky, give us all a vote.
Now here's track 4, the title track of the album, performed by Biohazard and Onyx.
Just
Now, this one is pretty similar to Onyx's biggest hit Slam, which came out earlier that year, except that it has a slightly different hook and there's distorted guitars on the beat. I like this one because I like soundtrack songs where the chorus lyrics include the title of the movie. Top 15 soundtrack songs where the chorus lyrics include the title of the movie.
Flash. Purple rain, purple rain.
Working 9 to 5.
Is your game start off?
Ghostbusters.
Alright, Judgement Night track 5, Ice-T with Slayer. This is actually a medley of three exploited covers, War, UK 82, and Disorder. The song is called Disorder. Rick Rubin produced this one. I'm gonna play this clip from Headbangers Ball real quick, and then we'll hear a bit of the song.
I guess got a call, and my manager just called me up. He says, yo, they want you to do
it. We don't need your war!
You know, a duo with some group. I'm like, what group? He says, a rock group. I said, I got a rock group. They like Slayer. I'm like, I'm there.
Our government is fucked. Sure to bring us down.
I know this is a series about music, but I gotta talk about another movie real quick. Back to the Future 2. Probably has a terrible soundtrack. I didn't look it up. Anyway, what I wanted to mention is this scene. You're familiar with it, maybe. Where Doc Brown explains the concept of parallel timelines to Marty. Spoiler, in the movie, old Biff Tannen brings the sports almanac back to young Biff and disrupts the good timeline. So now everyone's over in the bad timeline where middle-aged Biff has, let's say, inherited a bunch of money and is now a real crooked motherfucker with a bad hairpiece who's cheated his way into a position of power. Where am I going with this? I think the Judgement Night soundtrack was this thing that had us on like the good timeline for rap rock. See, those words feel gross to say, rap rock. And I think they sound like that, they have that gross connotation because of the direction the genre went and what we perceive it as today. So my theory is that sometime after the release of the Judgement Night soundtrack, something happened that put us on the bad rap rock timeline. And my thought is that thing was the 1997 release of Limp Bizkit's debut album, $3 Bill, y'all. The year that record came out, aka the event that put us on the bad timeline, Limp Bizkit did some dates opening for a band I love, another band that my friend Peter introduced me to, Faith No More. Now, Faith No More's Roddy Bottom had this to say about having Limp Bizkit open for them on tour. That guy Fred Durst had a really bad attitude, he was kind of a jerk. I remember he called the audience faggots at one show when they booed him. Not a good scene. So fuck Fred Durst and Limp Bizkit, but as far as Faith No More goes, let's move on to track 6 of the Judgement Night soundtrack. This is Faith No More with the Booyah Tribe from Southern California. This is another standout for me. This one is called Another Body Murdered. It maybe feels a little new metal. You could definitely argue that, but it's like good timeline new metal. Okay, here's track 7. Only a few more to go. This is Cypress Hill's first of two collabs on here. It's with Sonic Youth, and it's called I Love You, Mary Jane. Shout out to Cypress Hill for staying on brand. Also some good timeline material, I think. It's not surprising that early 1990s Sonic Youth composed something super cool that complemented Cypress Hill's style and simultaneously felt at home in the Sonic Youth catalog. Next track. This is the ultimate Seattle collab. Here's Mudhoney with Sir Mix-a-Lot. This one is called Freak Mama, and while both artists are really in their own individual pockets, it is just way too silly. Here's a little bit of it. Watch out for the name drop on this one.
like it ain't funny. Yep, 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 Peter Piper couldn't pimp.
Okay, and then one quick thing that Sir Mix-a-Lot says at the end is also really funny.
Just lost my street credibility, y'all.
I like that Sir Mix-a-Lot thinks that this is the song that ruined his credibility. Track 9. This is another favorite. Dinosaur Jr. with Del the Funky Homo Sapien, Missing Link. Rather than play the studio version of this one, I want to play this live version that both artists played on the Arsenio Hall show, because it's a really good crew. Del and Dinosaur Jr. plus Mike Watt from the Minutemen on bass, and Mike D from the Beastie Boys on the drums.
My next guests are combining alternative rock with pure rap for a sound that's simply blowing up, performing Missing Link. Please welcome Dinosaur Jr. and Del the Funky Homo Sapien.
Peace. Now check this out. My name is Del. This is Dinosaur Jr. We about to show you how we do it. Out east, so let's check it out. Hey, I got a story. This is the quarter, off the sword. Dinosaur Jr. will find us for the ruin. But in blazes, hey, this fat wages. I display this.
Yes, Del continuing the trend of mentioning your soundtrack collaborator's name in your verse. Nice. It's probably unfair to subject music from a quarter century ago to hold up in present day, considering how much changes over time, but this song in particular really holds up. Maybe it's because both Del and Dinosaur Jr. are still out here, and their sound hasn't strayed too far from something that was already good. Give the studio version a listen, it rules. If I made you a mixtape in high school, this was probably on there. Track 10, one more after this. This one, 27 years after its release, probably now has the least recognizable names. Therapy from Northern Ireland, with Fatal, who is an artist from the Soul Assassins, a crew that was managed by none other than Judgement Night soundtrack executive producer Happy Walters. A previous liner notes reader Rob Severe pointed out something that I didn't know, that Fatal is Joe Fatal, the second rapper and least famous person on Main Sources Live at the Barbecue. So here's a little bit of Therapy and Fatal, Come and Die. So the needle on that one is definitely pointing a bit more towards the rap metal end of things. But all the same, I'm just gonna call this one good timeline rap metal. Listen, I'll admit my vision might be a little skewed because of how much this soundtrack shaped my adolescent musical tastes. I've definitely mentioned it in a number of interviews as a thing that influenced the Hood Internet, much to the chagrin of Aaron Brink from the Hood Internet. Here's an email he wrote me in 2012 while we were promoting an album we'd made. This looks good. Maybe a conversation for a different time, but I'm not wanting to overdo the Judgement Night soundtrack comparisons. Could give people an overly simplistic idea of what the record is, rapper rapping over music by rock act. Also not so sure that most people have as fond memories of that record as you do, and may remember it as rap metal. Not unfair, but in all honesty, there probably wouldn't have been a The Hood Internet had there never been a music from the motion picture Judgement Night. Okay, track 11, last one, here we go. Cypress Hill is back, and they brought Pearl Jam with them. We got the Pearl Jam name drop in the verse. Let's fast forward just a bit.
When I'm neath the hill, I struck with a swoop.
Clack, clack, bang, bang.
Two name drops, Pearl Jam the whole band, and then a bonus shout out to guitarist Stone Gossard. This one maybe isn't as strong as Cypress Hill's earlier collab on the record, the one with Sonic Youth. The Pearl Jam guitars sound nice, but it's a descending chord progression, pretty cliche for rap, and it kind of doesn't seem like either party is really feeling it. I mean, I wasn't there, so I don't know. But they did put this song last on the album, and it didn't even appear in the movie. Which technically means this should be called music from and inspired by the motion picture Judgement Night, but it's beside the point. Now what is the point? It's time to wrap this up. Let's go back to this good timeline, bad timeline thing. Remember? Limp Bizkit fucked the whole thing up in 1997, and then suddenly there's bands like Trapped and Taproot, and probably Traproot. But just like Old Biff in Back to the Future 2, did someone travel back through time to put us on this course? Someone who, like Biff, inherited a bunch of money and is now a real crooked motherfucker with a bad hairpiece who's cheated his way into a position of power. Someone who wears a red hat. In conclusion, I believe that Fred Durst is also Donald Trump, and it's both of their faults that we're in this mess. My research supports this claim, and it is 100% true. Thank you very much. Please vote for Joe Biden and Kamala Harris on November 3rd.
Disappeared.
Alright, yeah.
Well, how is that possible?
I don't know.
Thank you.
different.